Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn all about Google Analytics certification. I'll share tips for studying for the Google Analytics certification exam so you can earn your Google Analytics individual qualification. We'll explore the topics that are covered in the exam. I'll talk about the benefits of being qualified in Google Analytics, and I'll answer some frequently asked questions, including if Google Analytics 4 is covered in the exam. Okay, let's jump in and get started. We're going to begin by covering some frequently asked questions about the certification. If you would prefer to jump ahead, then you can find links to each topic in the description below this video. Okay, the first question is, does the exam cover Google Analytics 4, GA4, which is the new version of Google Analytics? Well, no, the exam doesn't cover the new version of Google Analytics. I sat the exam today, and all of the questions I was asked referred to Universal Analytics, which is the previous version of Google Analytics. When will the exam be updated? I honestly don't know when Google will update the exam. My guess is that Google will likely add a new, separate certification sometime in the future to cover Google Analytics 4, but I don't know when this will be. How much does it cost to get certified in Google Analytics? The exam is free to take, so while you don't need to pay anything to become certified, you will need to invest some of your time to study for the exam. How long is the certification valid? Once you've passed the exam, the certification is valid for 12 months. And to keep your certification, you'll need to retake your exam before it expires. Is there a demo account I can use to help study for the exam? Yes, there are Google Analytics demo accounts that Google makes available. They're a great way to become familiar with the different reports available in Google Analytics. You can find a link to access the demo account in the description below this video. Is Google Analytics certification worth it? I absolutely think the Google Analytics certification is important. Think about this scenario. If you're interviewing for a new job and your skills and experience are similar to another candidate, but you have your certification, who do you think they will hire? So getting certified shows you're committed and interested in Google Analytics. Should I cheat to pass the exam? While the certification can help you stand out, it's not going to get you your dream job or land your next client. It's really about your experience that's going to do that. So no, I wouldn't cheat on the exam. It's pretty easy to tell who knows Google Analytics and who just copied answers to pass the exam. How should I study for the exam? Google provides a number of resources to help you study for the exam. First, there's Google's Analytics Academy, which is home to Google's free courses that you can take in your own time. Google recommends completing the Google Analytics for Beginners and the Advanced Google Analytics courses before taking the exam. The courses are primarily made up of video lessons, but there is also the option to read through the lessons if you prefer. And I also recommend checking out my special Google Analytics Study Guide, which is a condensed version of Google's learning resources. My study guide makes it quicker and easier to learn and refresh on the most important exam topics. You can find details about my study guide in the description below this video. I also recommend that if you are going to take the exam for the first time, that you spend some time exploring Google Analytics. Being familiar with the interface and getting to know the reports will make passing the exam easier. And don't forget, you can also access the demo account if you don't have access to a real set of reports. How hard is the exam? There are a mix of questions. You'll probably find some questions are easy and some are difficult. It really comes down to how you've studied for the exam and your previous experience using Google Analytics. What are the exam questions like? All of the questions are multiple choice, so you'll need to select the best possible answer from the available options. The questions cover a broad range of topics from basic principles, what's contained in particular reports, through to more technical questions about browser cookies and how the tracking code works. Let's look at four practice questions. These are based on the types of questions you might find in your exam. The first question is, which of the following are recommended when using campaign tags? Is the answer A, medium, source and campaign, B, content, source and term, C, campaign, content and term, or D, medium, source and content? What do you think is the correct answer? The correct answer is A. Google recommends using medium sourcing campaign when using campaign tags for your inbound marketing. The next practice question is, which report shows you the geographic location of your users? Is the answer A, demographics overview, B, geolocation, C, behavior engagement, or D, custom user defined? What do you think? The correct answer is B, geolocation. Next up, what are the four scopes available for dimensions and metrics in Google Analytics? Is the answer A, hit level, session level, product level, or user level scope? B, location level, duration level, product level, or user level scope? C, event level, session level, transaction level, or user level scope? Or D, event level, duration level, transaction level, or user level scope? What do you think? The correct answer is A, hit level, session level, product level, or user level scope. And the final practice question is, which of the following represents the structure of a Google Analytics account? Is the answer A, property, account, and view, B, account, view, and property, C, account, property, and view, or D, view, account, and property? What do you think the correct answer is? The correct answer is C, account, property, and view. And just to note, this is the correct structure for a universal analytics property. So there's some examples of the types of questions you might find in the exam. Your exam will include 70 randomized questions, so you'll need to be prepared on all of the possible exam topics. If you'd like to test yourself with even more practice questions, then you can find a link to my Google Analytics exam practice questions in the description below this video. You have 1.5 hours to take the exam, and you'll need to get at least 80% of the questions correct in order to pass the exam. Once you have passed the exam, your certificate will be current for 12 months. How do we sit the exam? The exam is free to take and you can sit the exam in Google Skill Shop. Let's take a look. You will need to log in with your Google account, like your Google Workspace login or your Gmail login. Then you can select Browse, then select Analytics Academy, and select Google Analytics Individual Qualification. Or you can search on the top of the window. You can find the study resources, which are just links to Google's Analytics Academy, at the bottom of the page. When you're ready to take the exam, click Google Analytics Individual Qualification Exam, and you'll immediately start the exam. And if you need to retake the exam, you can find the option towards the top of the page. How do I download my certificate? I'm not sure if it's just me, but I found it impossible to find the certificate through the regular navigation. So here's my tip. After you've passed the exam, you can select View Award. You can also find this by selecting your profile on the top right corner of the interface. Once you're looking at your award, we just need to modify the URL. We need to remove student/award and change this to enrollments/download_certificate. When we load this URL, you should see the PDF version of your certificate, which is much nicer than the award page we saw previously. What happens if you fail the Google Analytics exam? If you do fail the exam, you'll have to wait one day before trying the exam again. And there isn't a penalty for failing the exam, other than having to wait for your next attempt. So that's how you can take the Google Analytics certification exam and the resources you can use to study for the exam. Remember that once you've passed the exam, you'll be able to say that you have your Google Analytics individual qualification, print out your certificate, and add your qualification to LinkedIn and your CV. Are you starting to become a Google Analytics qualified individual? Or are you already qualified? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget you can test your Google Analytics knowledge with even more of my practice questions. I've included a link in the description below this video. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.